I'm Jason Shepherd, and these are the fundamentals. What's happening here, MzeroA Nation? Jason Shepherd here, now into episode 2 of The Fundamentals. We're diving into some flight maneuvers now, and I'm going to be showing you one of my favorite combinations. Again, we learned in episode 1 about some mixed practice. We're going to be interleaving some maneuvers here as well, as I want you to go from slow flight clean to slow flight dirty to a power off stall, but staying all in a maneuver constantly. Allow me to demonstrate. I've already knocked in my clearing turns. Let me get established on a south heading here. And as you can see here, we're at roughly 3,500 feet south heading. Let's do slow flight in the clean configuration here real quick. So slow flight in the clean configuration. Carby comes on, power comes back, pitching for airspeed, powering for altitude is what I'm going to do here. Pitching for airspeed, powering for altitude. I'm starting to give it a little bit of power. I want to be around, I'm a little slower than I'd like to be right now. I want to be more like 63, 64 is where I'd like to be. If I was doing PTS slow fly, I could hang this thing by the stall warning horn. I'm 20 feet low. What should I do? I should add a little bit of power here. I have to break this descent. Give it some power. Give it some power. Give it some power. There, I've broken the descent. Let's get back to roughly where we need to be. And let's work this through, holding our south heading, 61, 60, I'm okay with that here. If I get too slow, what do? I lower the nose a little bit. Could you get this trimmed up to where you could be flying this hands-free? I got a little bit of a climb, bring some power back, bring some power back. She likes to climb. You got to catch that descent early. When you start getting away in the 300s and stuff, it gets away from you very, very quickly. All right, that's looking good. All is looking set, holding here. All right. Why don't we go a left heading around to, let's go north in this case. Okay, can we do that? Let's do a big turn all the way around to north. Clear left, clear left. Let's go. And again, my ailerons are not very effective in this configuration. So I'm just going to baby my way around. Adjusting, again, ailerons, like we learned in our last video, are not doing a whole lot out there. There's a lot of rudder work here. My hands are kind of here. I'm just letting this airplane kind of work its way around. I'm fine with my speed. I don't hear the warning horn or anything like that. That's all looking good. I've got a little bit of a descent going, but again, what happens when I enter into a turn? I'm trading some horizontal and vertical components of lift. So a descent is kind of likely. You should anticipate that by giving it maybe a little bit of power. It's called slow flight for a reason. There is no reason to rush this turn on its way around. Baby your way around. Keep yourself nice and coordinated. A little bit of a, I'm kind of level, but I'm still 20 feet low, and on a glass panel plane, that bugs me. On a steam gauge plane, it wouldn't look like much of a difference at all, would it? We're just going to manage that all the way back around. That's looking really, really great. When we get around to a heading to north, we're going to do something different, and you can add turns to this. Again, you should be doing this with an instructor, please, and instructors, you should be doing this with your students. We're going to come all the way back around here, 3,500, airspeed, slide that 62-ish where I want to be. Here's north, rolling out, using rudders to stop that. I want to now, I'm in slow flight in the clean configuration. Don't forget I have that extra power. Look how it caught up with me, 100 feet per minute climb. I need that power through the turn, through changing through the vertical and horizontal components of lift. Now it's cost me 25, you know, 30, almost 40 feet. So I need to make that adjustment there as well. I want to now, I'm in clean slow flight. I want to now transition to slow flight in the dirty or landing configuration. I want to add flaps to the equation. You have two options. You can baby flaps in or you can dump them all the way in. I recommend you start babying the flaps in. Where's the nose going to want to go the moment I add these flaps in here? You ready? Keep my hand on the yoke here, 10 degrees of flaps. Look where that nose goes. I kind of have to push it forward, and in a second, I get a little bit of a climb. That's kind of like a false climb in a way. It's propelling you up, and look, just like that, it switches to a descent. So if anything, I need to add a little bit of power. Next notch of flaps. Push my nose forward, take a little bit of that trim out. I don't need as much anymore. A little more power. Just watch it here. Watching my speed as well, okay? That's looking good. Next notch of flaps. And I've got all the way to 40. I'm at 30 right now. Lowering that nose a little bit, holding north. I got a little bit of a climb going on. Take some, I got a little aggressive with my power maybe. But see that? A much flatter pitch outside, by the way. By the way, it's so easy to get glued right here. Don't forget to fly the airplane out in front of you here. Last notch of flaps, here it comes. Nose wants to come up. Let's trim it up. Let's see, what are we working with? I'm on north, about 100 foot per minute climb. That's gonna get ugly here in a second. Take a load of power out. That might have been too much. Let's just watch it and see. You should always be trimming up so you can be hands-free with this. So you're just flying with two fingers, three fingers max. No death grips. I used to yell at students, not yell at students, but you'd see students and their veins would be bulging. Like the yoke is gonna break off in your hand. Anybody, leave me a comment below. Anybody ever have a death grip on the yoke before? We're just holding this here. My speed is awesome. I've got a big descent though. Let's fix that real quick. I'm almost within the green arc on my power. You could come carb heat off if I wanted to. There it is. Let's see if that arrests that. I believe it does. And we're back to life looking pretty great. Okay, here is the last step of this mixed practice. We did slow flight clean. We added a turn to it. You could add turn or turns. You could add some turns here if you want. For brevity, I won't. But it's very, very similar. Again, ailerons not doing a whole lot. It's all about the rudder work. Now I want to take it to a power off stall. I want you to hold the same pitch that you have out front here. I just want you to bring the carburetor heat back on. I want you to hold the same pitch. And I want you to baby the power back. This is not bringing the power back. You hear that still Warren horn? I don't know how well you can hear that. It comes right on. Hold it, hold it, hold it. And just like that, there's our stall. Carburetor heat, full power. Flaps. Go right to 20 in this aircraft. You got to know what your go-around procedure is. Flaps, right to 20. We've got that. Okay, we're climbing on out here. Through 70, flaps to 10. Looking good. I like to peek outside. Flaps did come up evenly, coming up evenly here. Pause rate of climb. Flaps up and out. And that, my friends, life is good. We practice stalls to practice recoveries, not to practice how to get into stalls. Good work on that one. Take our flight maneuvers and kind of combine them into one maneuver. It's a unique way to look at things. I know it sounds a little bit crazy, but I'll promise you one thing, it's going to all make sense by the end of this series. Hey, speaking of the series is going to end with a phenomenal live stream. On March 30th at 8 p.m. Eastern Time, I'm going live via Zoom. I want to see your smiling faces. I'm tired of all this COVID stuff and everything else. Like, I want to get to air shows and trade shows and see you all again. It's been forever. So I want to see your smiling faces via Zoom. Looking forward to that. Head over to MzeroAlive.com to sign up. Obviously, Zoom can only fit so many seats. So if you want your smiling face to be in there, get signed up. If you can't, we will email you the recording. Still sign up like you're going to be there. So at least we have your email to send you the recording. So it'll be on Zoom, MzeroAlive.com to check this out. If you haven't seen episode one, it's a long episode, but you need to go back with that. It's all about the fundamentals of landings. I even share some seaplane pilot techniques in there you're going to want to see. Listen, MZero Nation, have a blessed, amazing, outstanding rest of your day. And most importantly, remember, a good pilot is always learning. Have a great day, everyone. We'll see ya.